Did you know that every piece of electronics that we currently rely on, from electric cars to smartphone to AI, is powered by semiconductor? It's a massive, fast-growing global industry, and today we are taking a closer look at one of the most exciting new players in the field. This is Vietnam. You might know Vietnam as a global manufacturing hub that starts to get more and more traction into fields such as electronic, PCB and PCBA. In today's video, let's dive into what Vietnam makes this semiconductor industry so promising. Before we get into the topic of this video, we are moved to Asia, your go-to sourcing partner in Vietnam. We can assist foreign buyers from finding the right supplier, doing due diligence on their behalf, organizing factory tour, taking care of the entire production process with quality control. We also have a warehouse for mixed container consolidation. In fact, we can act as your grounded team in the country to take care of the entire scope of your production need. If you want to manufacture electronic projects, Vietnam should be definitely on your radar just because of the current late development in PCB, PCBA, and the upcoming trend for semiconductor. So let's start by seeing where the semiconductor industry stands today and some of the stats that are very impressive. First, in terms of market growth projections, Vietnam semiconductor market is expected to reach 7 billion by 2028, growing at around 6.7% annually from 2023 to 2028. Even more exciting, Statista projects a faster compound annual growth rate of 11% by 2027, bringing revenue to a projected $31 billion. And with the integrated circuit segment alone valued at $16 billion by 2024, it's clear that this sector is thriving. Also, Vietnam has a strong foreign investment sector with big tech players like Intel, Samsung, Qualcomm are already here setting up operation focus on assembly and packaging. Third criteria is Vietnam's location with a major advantage close to markets like China, Japan and South Korea. It's a plus point with labor costs that are competitive. Fourth component, we have a rising global demand for semiconductors due to AI, IoT and 5G. Vietnam has a unique chance to expand its footprint in this crucial industry, meeting with global needs that will strengthen its own position in the supply chain. So while this current landscape in the semiconductor industry is on the rise, there are some couple of factors why Vietnam should definitely be one of the go-to destinations for big and small players to consider it as a manufacturing country in the next years. First reason, Vietnam has a geographical advantage. With Vietnam's location in the heart of Southeast Asia, places it close to major tech market for importing key materials, including copper foil, silicon wafer, rare metals, and advanced equipment. And Vietnam is about to get a distinct edge, especially for labor-intensive processes like assembling, packaging, and testing, which are essential to the semiconductor supply chain. Third reason, we have government support, and the Vietnamese government is fully behind this industry and has implemented policies to make the country the prime investment destination, including tax break, land rent exemptions, and infrastructure improvements. Lastly, Vietnam signed a couple of trade agreements with some key markets and partnerships. Countries like France recently elevated their collaboration to a comprehensive strategic partnership is placing France as the first EU country aimed at attracting French investors. Before we discuss more about the semiconductor industry, the current state in the market, the upcoming development with its opportunity, and the challenges that this industry may encounter in Vietnam, let's have an overall understanding about the PCB and PCBA lines in Vietnam. PCB is a printed circuit board and PCBA are the printed circuit board assembly. And these areas are vital in the electronics manufacturing industry and closely linked to semiconductor application. As PCBs are essential components for assembling and integrating semiconductor chips into electronic devices, it's important to have an understanding about the current landscape in Vietnam. First, Vietnam has a diverse scale in this sector, with Vietnam is home as an expansive network from small to big scale PCB and PCBA manufacturers supported by a strong electronics manufacturing base. Global electronics giants like Samsung, Foxconn, LG, Panasonic has established significant production facilities in Vietnam, creating demand for local PCB suppliers to support high volume manufacturing. This growth has attracted additional smaller scale players in this manufacturing industry, making Vietnam as a scalable option for companies looking to test the market, research and develop new electronic products, and produce circuit board for consumer electronics, automotive component and industrial applications. Vietnam also has a strong export demand, with a demand that is not only driven by domestic manufacturers, but also by foreign companies using Vietnam as an export base for electronic devices. Regarding its capabilities, Vietnam also have an advanced technology with Vietnam's PCB manufacturer that are investing in more sophisticated capabilities to meet the rising demand of high density interconnected, also called HDI, boards, multi-layer boards, and rigid flex boards, which are essential for advanced electronics and devices with higher data processing needs. Lastly, Vietnam has a vertical integration with a synergy between Vietnam's semiconductor industry and PCB, PCBA manufacturing, offering a potential for vertical integration where components can be designed, tested, assembled, and even packaged within Vietnam. As the country continues to develop advanced capabilities, Vietnam's role in the global PCB landscape is expected to expand and integrate with the development of its semiconductor industry. So what are the areas of strength and potential in Vietnam's semiconductor industry? While high-end manufacturing and advanced semiconductor design remain future goals, the country has already demonstrated competitive advantages in certain key segments. First, Vietnam has developed robust capabilities in assembly, packaging and testing, called APT, often referred as the back end of semiconductor manufacturing. Companies like Intel, Amkor and Signetics have set up large-scale APT facilities in Vietnam, taking advantage of its cost-effective labor force and operational efficiencies. As the stages are labor intensive and critical to the supply chain, Vietnam's established expertise here make it an attractive destination for companies seeking for reliable, scalable APT operations. This segment is likely to remain a stronghold for Vietnam as it further solidifies its role in the semiconductor supply chain. Second, we have integrated circuits called IC design support and testing services. While IC design itself is a developing area, Vietnam has shown potential in IC design support and testing services, where a growing pool of skilled engineers is beginning to contribute to global R&D teams. Companies such as Marvell and Global Foundries are investing in design centers in Vietnam, signaling confidence in the country's capacity to support design processes. This trend is likely to expand, and with continued talent development, Vietnam could emerge as a significant player in IC design support, working alongside larger design centers in neighboring countries. Third key segment, we have the memory and consumer electronics component. With major investment from companies like Samsung and 3M, Vietnam is gaining momentum in producing memory components and consumer electronics parts that incorporate semiconductors. This area aligns with Vietnam's exciting manufacturing strengths in electronics and the global demand for memory chips and related components. So you understand that the awareness for Vietnam as a key player in the semiconductor industry is on rise. What are some of the key projects and investments that spread out on the news to highlight its potential? And here are some of the most exciting developments. Signetics Corporation Investment is a South Korean firm that invested $100 million to build a semiconductor plant in Bingpuk province. Scheduled to open by the end of 2025, this facility will focus on high-demand tech components like memory chips and GPUs, a great addition to Vietnam's semiconductor landscape. Amkor is a US-based company that has committed to invest $1.6 billion to its Vietnam operation, including a $520 million factory in Bac Ninh that opened in October 2023. This move reinforces Amkor's role in the global supply chain and highlights Vietnam's appeal to industry leaders. Finally, we got 3M Corporation, a US-based company that opened a center in Hanoi focused on science, tech, and engineering. This move shows Vietnam's growing importance in the semiconductor and electronic field, with 3M supporting advanced solutions and innovation. So all of these key players are reinforcing their presence in Vietnam or building up new manufacturing plants. What is the future for the semiconductor industry in the country? Vietnam aims to build one semiconductor chip fabrication plant and 10 assembly packaging and testing factories by 2030. The government expects this effort to generate up to $25 billion in annual revenues, a big leap that promises immense growth for the industry. This flood of foreign investment puts Vietnam on the map as a strategic hub for semiconductor manufacturing, and Vietnam has a clear vision for where it wants to go in the semiconductor by 2023. The National Innovation Center, NIC, has also been set up to foster collaboration and talent across sectors, ensuring long-term and sustainable growth. Although the future seems to be bright for this semiconductor industry, there are still challenges and hurdles that Vietnam will have to face if they want to develop and master its industry. Although the Vietnamese government supports the growth of this industry, talent shortages and technological gaps are some of the difficulties Vietnam will have to tackle. First aspect is the global competition, and to compete with established semiconductor leaders like in China, the US, South Korea, and Europe, which have long-lasting ecosystems, Vietnam need to invest more in research and develop niche specialization within the semiconductor value chain. Second challenge is talent shortages. Skilled talent is crucial, particularly in high-end roles like IC design and testing, but Vietnam faces a shortage in those areas. The government's goal is to train 50,000 engineers by 2030 is a step forward, but collaboration with universities, industry programs, and international partnerships will likely be necessary to fully close the talent gap and keep up with industry needs. Lastly, regarding technological, advanced manufacturing also requires access to state-of-the-art technology where Vietnam is still building its capacity. Looking forward, Vietnam has a golden opportunity to become a key player in the semiconductor industry, and ongoing reforms are set to enhance its competitiveness and position against other semiconductor hubs. So as you understood, right now we are not yet at the stage that Vietnam can do 100% electronic projects in Vietnam. It will need to rely on importing raw materials and rely on some key strategic countries to be able to assemble, test and develop such projects. Nevertheless, if you are a new entrant in this industry, you are looking to manufacture OEM projects in Vietnam, there are still room to go, and you can identify some key players like PCB, assembly lines, lighting, LED that can get you a first step into your manufacturing project. So how can you find an engaged discussion in such potential suppliers? The first channel that you can use is to contact association. You should contact such association in the semiconductor electronic industry. They may be able to share with you some of their members' contact. The second channel that you can use is to visit Vietnam and attend one of the trade shows happening either in Ho Chi Minh City or Hanoi. You have the Vietnam International Electronics and Smart Appliance Expo and Semicon Vietnam that you can attend physically. You can go to some networking events, attend to the discussions with some key industry leaders, or just get a first understanding about the key player attending today's shows. The third channel that you can use is acquire and purchase a list of potential manufacturers in the electronic industry. We do provide through our do-it-yourself sourcing course a list of 3,000 plus suppliers, manufacturers in Vietnam in different fields, and we do have some in the electronic sector. You find below more details in the description about those products and services. And if you need our help, our assistance to look for the suitable supplier or do due diligence on your behalf, visit the production line, get in touch with the key decision maker in the factory. You can send us your inquiry, tell us the type of product you are looking for, the MOQ, and then the country you wish to export, and we can deploy our team to look for the most suitable supplier. Again, everything is below in the description, so I'll let you check that. If you have any questions, any matters you would like to discuss, you can also leave us a comment below. Drop us your question and we will answer them fast. If you enjoy the video, leave a thumbs up and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Bye-bye. And I'ma get it right, then I'll sight like